নমস্কার, শুভ অপরাহ্ন, এ ভেরি গুড আফটারনুন টু অল অফ ইউ। অন বিহাফ অফ অর্গানাইজিং কমিটি, আই মিন্টু হালদার, ওয়ান অফ দ্য কনভেনার অফ দিস ওয়েবিনার, কর্ডিয়ালি ইনভাইট ইউ অল ইন দ্য ওয়েবিনার অন লাইব্রেরি সার্ভিসেস ডিউরিং COVID-19 প্যান্ডেমিক স্ট্র্যাটেজিস ফর একাডেমিক লাইব্রেরিজ। ওয়েবিনার ইজ অর্গানাইজড জয়েন্টলি বাই দ্য ইনফোলিপ একাডেমিয়া ইন কোলাবোরেশন উইথ ভৈরব গাঙ্গুলি কলেজ। উই আর কারেন্টলি গোয়িং থ্রু এ ডিফিকাল্ট টাইম। We are hearing from the news channel that the number of COVID patients is breaking its own record every day. We hope that very soon we will be able to return to our normal life. All know that the library is the heart of any academic institution. If the heart of that academic institution shuts down, then the existence of the academic institution will be in crisis. Today's topic is how we can keep our heart alive in this pandemic situation. In this program, the name of the resource persons are Dr. Biplab Chakraborty, Professor DLIS, University of Calcutta, Dr. Aurobindo Maiti, Professor, Department of Library Information Science, University of Calcutta, Dr. Ashish Kumar Karan, Librarian, Kalicharan Ghosh Mahavidyalaya, Dr. Sudeep Banerjee, Librarian, City College of Commerce and Administration, Ms. Bonnie Ghosh, Librarian, Loreto College, Dr. Subal Kumar Barui, Deputy University Librarian, University of Calcutta. I request to participants to place your question in that chat box on YouTube. We inform the participants that the feedback link will be provided in the YouTube chat box. You can download the certificate from BGC MOOCs. The program encouraged by our Honorable Vice Principal Dr. Sanjit Kumar Das. I request to our Vice Principal to deliver his welcome address. Over to sir.
Thank you, Sri Haldar. Good afternoon and welcome to this webinar on library services during COVID-19 pandemic, strategies for academic libraries, organized by the InfoLib Academia and in association with the Bhairav Ganguly College. First of all, I express my sincere gratitude to the webinar director, Dr. Biplab Chakraborty, Professor, Department of Library and Information Science, University of Calcutta, and the honorable keynote speaker, Dr. Aurobindo Maiti, Professor, Department of Library and Information Science, University of Calcutta, for sharing their valuable time with us and enlighten us about the different perspectives of today's topic of the webinar. I also express my gratitude to Dr. Shubal Kumar Bauri of Calcutta University, Ms. Bonnie Ghosh of Loreto College, Dr. Sudeep Banerjee of City College of Commerce and Business Administration, and Dr. Ashish Kumar Karan of Kalicharan Ghosh College for their consent as a speaker in this webinar and for the deliberation of our distinguished speakers. I express my thanks to Dr. Abdul Salam and Kimintu Haldar, the convener of this webinar, for taking all necessary arrangements and for their dedicated efforts in materializing the today's academic endeavor. You know that we have already crossed five months in COVID-19 pandemic situation and seen how the world has been changed and increasing unemployment, reduction of GDP is observed everywhere. And naturally, the entire world economy is in crisis and the socioeconomic life of the people has been changed dramatically everywhere due to a small virus. And each and every community is severely been affected. And in this academic world, we have seen a lot of changes and the teachers and students are staying at home and moving forward through this online system. There are certain problems the students are facing and teachers are also facing, but there is no other opportunity than to move with this online mode only. And you know that threats and opportunities go side by side. There are certain threats, but at the same time, there are certain opportunities in this lockdown period. We are staying at home, rethink ourselves, reorganizing ourselves with participation in webinar conferences, faculty development programs, and we are getting new ideas and rethinking ourselves about our academic players. So it's a benefit and it's an opportunity for all of us. And the librarian, they have a special job in hand. And Rabindranath Bulletin, যে নিজেকে এগিয়ে গিয়ে পাঠককে অভ্যর্থনা করে করে আনে তাকেই বলি বদান্য। সে হলো বড় বড় লাইব্রেরি, আকৃতিতে নয় প্রকৃতিতে। সো নাও ইটস দ্য টাইম টু রিচ দেম উইথ অল ইউর রিসোর্সেস অ্যান্ড ফ্রম টুডেজ ডিসকাশন উইল গেট ডেফিনিট রোড ম্যাপ টু কাম আউট উইথ আওয়ার বেস্ট টু সার্ভ আওয়ার বিলাভেড স্টুডেন্টস অ্যান্ড ফ্রম দ্য অ্যাডমিনিস্ট্রেটিভ পয়েন্ট অফ ভিউ দ্য হেড অফ দ্য ইনস্টিটিউশন অলওয়েজ ডিপেন্ডস অন সাম কলিগস who are energetic, efficient, and always tries to work hard for the institution. I am fortunate to have my bursar and librarian, Sumin Haldar, is always with me. And even this in lockdown period of 5 months, we have always 5 days in our college so that nothing remains pending. So I request all of you to extend your hands and cooperate the head of the institution so that
sir, please unmute yourself.
Hello.
Carry on.
Hello.
Sir, carry on, please.
Now it is okay.
Huh?
Shona jacche to?
Sir.
Mane start korbo. Start korbo. হ্যালো
না বাকি বাকিটা বাকিটা শেষ করুন বলে
হ্যাঁ সো আই থ্যাংক ইউ অল অফ ইউ প্লিজ এনজয় দ্য সেশন স্টেইং এট হোম এন্ড আই রিকোয়েস্ট শ্রী হালদার টু কন্টিনিউ দ্য সেশন
থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার ফর ইউর এনকারেজিং ভ্যালুয়েবল স্পিচ নাও আই রিকোয়েস্ট মাই কলিগ ডক্টর আবুল সালাম ওয়ান অফ দ্য কনভেনার ইন দিস ওয়েবিনার টু ইন্ট্রোডিউস দ্য স্পিকার Over to Dr. Salam.
Good afternoon, everybody. You all welcome to this webinar platform. The webinar title is Library Services During COVID-19 Pandemic, Strategies for Academic Libraries. We all know that this is the situation of during this pandemic situation. It is our tough job how to provide our services to the to our users. So on that particular respect, we organize the webinar today in the platform of InfoLib Academia, which is a platform for all type of library services. And now we are providing the webinar platform in collaboration with the Bhairav Ganguly College, Belghoria. And in this webinar, on today's topic, we have invited our keynote speaker, Professor Dr. Aurobindo Maiti. He's the professor of University of Calcutta. And then our other speakers will be there. Dr. Ms. Bonnie Ghosh will deliver her valuable thought. She's librarian of Loreto College. And now, after that, we would like to hear from Dr. Sudeep Banerjee. He is the librarian of City College of Commerce and Business Administration. He is also bursar of that particular institution. Then with us, Dr. Ashish Kumar Karun. He is the associate scale librarian of Kali Charan Ghosh Torai Mahavidyalaya. It is located in North Bengal. And after his thoughtful deliberation, we would like to hear from Dr. Shubal Kumar Barui. He is the deputy university librarian of our University of Calcutta. These are the speakers for the day. Hope you will be, we all enrich from their thoughtful deliberation of speech. Now, I would like to deliver the speaker, mic and camera to our respected, who is the main mastermind of this program, our beloved sir, who is the director of Info Library Academia and with this webinar, who is the chairman also in Philip. We all know that the name of this person is Professor Dr. Biplab Chakraborty, and he is now we all know that he is now the renowned person in national level also, national level as well as international. And in the case of research supervision, we all know that he is the leading supervisor on our particular subject in the country. And next to our beloved sir, sir, please you carry on. Please unmute, sir. Sir, please unmute.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon to all. Thank you, Dr. Abul, respected Vice Principal of Bhairava Ganguly College, Dr. Sanjit Kumar Das, key speaker, Professor Aurobindo Maiti of Calcutta University, Dr. Subol Kumar Baroi of Calcutta University, Dr. Ashish Kumar Koron of Bagdogra Kalipada Ghosh College, Mahavidyalaya, Ms. Boni Ghosh from Loreto College, Dr. Sudeep Banerjee from City College of Commerce and Business Administration, teachers, colleagues of Bhairava Ganguly College, members of Info Live Academia, joint conveners, Dr. Abul Salam from Shibpur Dinobandhu Institution, and Mr. Mintu Haldar of Bhairava Ganguly, Librarian of Bhairava Ganguly College, and participants. At the outset, I want to convey my deepest gratitude to the organizers, especially my two students who are the conveners of this webinar, for inviting me to act as a director of this webinar. And in this context, I want to speak a little, because time is constant. A number of speakers are here in this webinar. They will be denied to get the justice because they will not get much more time. So, initially, I want to speak one or two sentences. During the pandemic situation due to coronavirus, the libraries are facing serious challenges to provide the requisite services to the users. So, in this webinar, we will discuss, that means our speakers will discuss on the various issues related to the services of the academic libraries in this COVID-19 situation. So, I think that our speakers will enlighten us about the challenges and the ways, that means how to overcome the situation in this webinar. So I don't want to speak much more. Though justice have denied, our speakers as ready to speak. So first I invite Professor Aurobindo Maiti, the professor of the Calcutta University Department of Library and Science, to deliver his keynote address.
Okay, thank you, sir. Very good afternoon to everybody. I feel proud for being present in this webinar on library services during COVID-19 pandemic, strategies for academic libraries, jointly organized by Info Library Academia and Bhairava Ganguly College. At first, I convey my regards to the webinar director, Dr. Biplab Chakraborty, Professor, Department of Library and Information Science, University of Calcutta, and the Honorable Vice Principal of the Bhairava Ganguly College, Dr. Sanjit Kumar Das. At first, I convey my regards, sir. I convey my thanks to the other speakers of this webinar, Ms. Boni Ghosh, Librarian of Loreto College, Kolkata, Dr. Subal Kumar Barui, Deputy University Librarian, University of Calcutta, Dr. Ashish Kumar Koron, Librarian, Kalipada Ghosh Torai Mahavidyalaya Bagdogra, Dr. Sudeep Banerjee, Librarian and Barsar, City College of Commerce and Business Administration, Kolkata. I also convey my thanks to joint conveners, Dr. Sheikh Abul Salam, Librarian, Shibpur Dinobandhu Institution, Howrah, and Sri Mintu Haldar, Librarian of Bhairava Ganguly College, and also my beloved, research scholar, and other dear professional colleagues different participants of various institutions and my dear research scholars and students. Now we are serious in pandemic situations, we know. And just 1 minute, I just share my screen so that I can, just 1 minute. Yeah. Hello, everybody. Can you see the my presentation? Hello.
Yes, carry on.
Hello. Okay.
Yes.
So during this pandemic situations, we are staying at home, students at home, and we all know that overall world, I think it has already been stagnant now. And if we go on the statistics on today, we have gone through that the total number of persons affected during this COVID all over the world is 2,25,77,398. In India, the number is 28,35,822. And in West Bengal, I think 1,25,922. So during these situations, all the institutions, I think it will be, it has already been closed. And that's why all the libraries totally closed. So during these situations, I think very much essential for the students to think for the library to serve the users in this situation, in this pandemic situations, and as well as if the situation is in control, then I think the library definitely will be open in near futures. I think then the library will think to provide the service. So my topics I just concentrated on in two parts are there. One is pandemic situations when the library is totally closed, and then what should be the services library should provide to the users. And in another situation, when in post-pandemic situations, post-pandemic, I never mean that the COVID-19 is disappears in future. My thing is that I think definitely it will, vaccinations will be appear, vaccination definitely will take, and in near future, the situations definitely will be controlled and library will reopen. In that situation, what should be the services we provide? First of all, during this COVID situations, mainly three categories of services any academic library they should provide. First one, to promote the public health awareness by creating and disseminating information relating to the preventive measures. Next one, to support the researchers, faculty members, or the information required. Means information to provide the related different types of related information regarding to COVID. So that type of information we should provide the latest developments also, latest literatures also. And third one, to meet the core needs of the regular library users. Regarding promotions of the public health, library should initiate online health consultations, various topics that may be embedded in it during these awareness programs, such as wearing masks or using the sanitizer or maintaining the physical distance, everything else. Share the originals and evidence-based information to those patients who have already recovered from during this COVID attack. I think if we have the data of those patients, and then we just consult after consulting of those, the regarding different information regarding of their lifestyle, their nutrition, if librarian can collect, and then they will share to the users, I think they will be benefited for that. In noticeable, library may put different types of information regarding the email ID and the names of the nearest doctors, hospitals, and their health centers or the nearest police station, so that any that information can be uploaded into website so the users, they can have the information. Importance of the physical distancing, you all know that. Implementation of the quarantine measures and avoid on how to use misinformation. From the point of view of the library, I think it is very much important. And because so many social medias are there, day by day we just have the information that is, most of them are the fake information or the misinformation, I think. And point of view of the library, we know that the if we know the exact source, means the who has already written those information, what is the affiliation of the author, anything else, then we can measure the evidence, means the authenticity of that information. So from that point of view, the librarian can provide. In these situations, the librarian can provide the medical staff or academic researchers the latest developments regarding the vaccinations or the diagnostic kits and published in different medical journals or various databases relating to the COVID-19. And core library service, library should provide through virtual supports. They should provide the reference service or online document delivery service using also the literature search. They just provide information regarding the web service. They will provide the different databases and ebook and e-journal so that the users, they can access the library. During this e-journals, one thing is that library may provide all the journals and that mean mentioned in their websites also. But I think if definitely library should may provide the service so that everybody can access. But some libraries provide the service only for my user. Then I think the IP and password should be provided by the library. Lending facilities may be provided. I think only the limited users in this regard. Online renewal facilities can be available. They just waive the fines for the overdue materials. Provide photocopy and also provide the scan copy of the required materials, mean journals or text articles also. Uploading the class lectures and class notes also. Institutional repositories, if they have already provided the institutional repository, I think through this institutional repositories, I think many informations they can provide to the respective users. For visually impaired users, library may provide just to convert the text materials into the audio format. Actually, World Health Property Organization, they have provided this type of guidelines, and that made materials may be uploaded in the website so that users, they can have the opportunity to go through this. Even publishers in this situation, they just come forward. And they have already provided the so many electronic journals or anything else, and that can be freely available into the website. So librarian point of view, I think they should mention those publishers and also their electronic materials into their website so that anybody can access. Such one thing I can mention in this regard, that J.K. Rowling, the renowned publisher, they have already uploaded the Harry Potter at Home into the website. So from 1st April 2020, so anybody can access. There are so many, I think, sites freely available in the website relating to the education. So there are so many databases also, so many materials are available, either textbooks or theses or the audios or the videos. I have just mentioned all those. I think everybody know NDLI, UKit portals, EPG Parsala, ePartsala, DellNet, NPTEL, Swarm, Online Labs, Saksat, Sodganga, and Krishikos. So one question is that anybody can arise this type of question. So everything can be available into the website. But on the other hand, whether all the users, they can be afford to use all the resources. I think we are all know that online mode may be a complement, but it is not the substitute of the total normal classroom. So that's why my questions arise in this way. We know that most of the users, they do not have the cell phones, do not have the laptop, do not have the desktop, they do not have the digital literacy also. They do not have the facility for network also, do not have the unlimited data. Therefore, all the resources, whatever be uploaded into the institutional website, I think, and freely accessible to all, but all users are not enjoying each facility. So I think our respective authorities should be taken into consideration into this year. Now we are concentrating on the post-pandemic situations when the situation is in control. And I think the library, they are thinking to reopen the library, reopen it. So that's why I think the permission may be granted and the library building and the library resources themselves should be clean first. In this regard, Japan Library Association has provided 4 suggestions. You should concentrate on that. First one, analyzing the risks from the surface, close contact with the people, the way in which the people use the library, and overall level of the infections of that particular disease. If we are thinking to reopen the library, of course, we should clean the environment. First means you should clean the stagnant air and stagnant water from the AC machines or from the water cooler or the air cooler. Implement the regular cleaning process, means mainly the surface area. So that's better way if we all the users, they just put up their shoes before entering the library. I think it is not possible at all. But in West Bengal and one library, we can know that Cultivation Association for the Cultivation of Science, still now they maintain any users, they have to put up their shoes before entering into the library. So door handles, keyboards, mouse, CDs, DVDs, toys of the virtual reality handsets, they should be cleaned regularly. Safety of the staff, you should be concentrated on that. Thermal screening should be ensured for all the persons. Removing obstacles, best way if there is no door, but if door is, we have in the so that in it should be totally open so that anybody can enter into the library without touching anything else. Limited number of users in these situations may allow it into the library, and they should maintain 3 to 4 feet among themselves. Allowed to enter the particular group of users, mainly the adult persons or those who have got the prior permissions. Removing some furniture so that we can have sufficient space within the library. Rearranging the space so that the users don't be sitting or standing face to face. Establishing one-way system so that the staff will move one way and the users will move the another way. To keep cells inaccessible, only library staff, they will fetch the documents, and keeping areas which should be socialistic closed in Australia or in Netherlands. We have already seen that coffee corner and the play corner is there in, within the library. And in this situation, I think that should be totally closed. Fully cloning space and only offering for the possibility of the borrow and return. And if we borrow and return, so I think the check-in and check facility, that should be mechanisms we should be adopted so that without interventions of the, without touch of everybody, human being, I think that can be done. Extending the loan period. And excuse the library fines, implementing quarantine periods, at least 72 hours in this regard. So many, I think, so many persons, so many organizations, they have tell us different ways. USA already set up the DLM along with the OCLC and the Battle Institutes. They have already provided the how many days for the quarantine periods, which is kept those books. Quarantine periods in different countries, they have already followed different days. I think Czechoslovakia, Netherlands, Switzerland, Belgium, Russia, they just followed 72 hours. And whether that is the Slovakia government has followed 5 days only. National level of China, they have already followed the using the isolations and the static sterilizations of the books. And in this regard, they just use the ultraviolet radiation, ozone disinfection. So that the quarantine days, I think it should be reduced from 72 hours to I think 3 or 4 hours. And library service during these situations, I think it should be concentrated on that. Cell service mode should be adopted, and virtual alternatives should be adopted. I think the rise of the open content, open educational resources should be used for that. Support for online teaching, the library website such a virtual point good, and I think the library website should be updated regularly. Reduce student study space and disappearance of the public technology. That is more important. In any library, so many computers are there, and before this pandemic situation, users, they just go to that particular computer room and they have already used those computers. But I think after pandemic situations, we should be thinking about that. Either we should day to day just sanitize all those computers. Otherwise, the users, they should bring their own laptops, own computers, and library should, I think, give the permissions for those. Remote service. Promote digital resources if available. Otherwise, they should create the digital resource during collection development. More concentrations on the, I think, the print versions rather than print copy. More concentrated on the soft copy. Library should provide. Promote virtual exhibitions or online article requests. Already, East West University, Bangladesh, they just providing this type of service. Already digitally, they just connected to the different universities abroad. One is Agricultural University Library of Colombia and Bharatpuj Library and Mexico and Roden University Library of South Africa. So after getting the query from the user, they just send it electronically to those libraries, and after collecting the data, they just send it to the respective users. Promoting hygiene, we should concentrate on that. Wash their hands frequently, access to the materials such as gloves and face masks and hand sanitizers, also thermal cleaners, I have already told. Use automatic machines to self-check out. Closing the toilet in case of Czechoslovakia public library, they have already stopped to no user they are using the toilet within the library. But in our state, I think it is not possible. But if we open the toilet, I think automatic flushing system should be adopted. Increasable materials means magazines and the newspapers that I think inaccessible, all the materials which is frequently used, and we should prevent the rare books and manuscript sections during this situation. And from the point of view of the staff, so definitely some measures we have to we should take it into consideration. Library should be open for limited hours. Rosters should be maintained among the library staffs. Promote home working, increase ventilations. Librarians also like to need to work with the reduced staff. And finally, avoid public communications. Libraries should take initiative so that they just provide the vehicles and through which the library staff, they can come to the library. Otherwise, the staff, I think if they avail the public vehicles, they should be affected. So so library should be, library authority should be taken care of. So this is my suggestions. So I think these measures should be taken and library should be provided during pandemic and after pandemic, these type of service. This is, that's it. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Professor Aurobindo Maiti. We are very much fruitful by getting your informative lecture. Now I invite one of the speakers, Miss Bonnie Ghosh, to deliver her address.
Thank you, sir. A very hearty afternoon to all of you. First of all, I would like to express my gratitude to Professor Dr. Biplab Chakraborty, Professor, Department of Library and Information Science, University of Calcutta, and director of today's webinar, for giving me this opportunity to express my views at the webinar. I would also like to thank Dr. Shankit Kumar Das, Vice Principal of the Bhairav Ganguly College, for extending his patronage towards this webinar. Dr. Das, we are grateful to you. With due respect to Professor Chakraborty, Dr. Das, the keynote speaker, Professor Dr. Aurobindo Maiti, Professor, Department of Library and Information Science, University of Calcutta, the conveners, fellow speakers, esteemed participants, faculty and students of Bhairav Ganguly College. Today, I would like to express my views on the expanding role of library professionals in higher education during and after the pandemic. Today, I am going to briefly highlight on some specific issues on the role of librarians during and after this pandemic. At the beginning, let us have a glimpse of paradigm shifts in the working of an academic library, which have mainly taken place along with changes in development of ICT. It may be said that application of ICT in libraries started with library automation. With the help of standard integrated library management system, several operations are performed, including acquisition, cataloging, member management, circulation, serials control, interlibrary lending, and also we are giving access to online public access catalog for student community as well as user community, I would rather say. With the introduction of ICT, the nature of the job of the librarian changed to a considerable extent. The nature of library collection gradually changed with the introduction of internet and World Wide Web. Information explosion followed. The role of librarian in this context is well brought out in the words of Neil Gaiman, an English author In 2010, he was appointed honorary chair of National Library Week in the US. In the same year, he spoke about the changing role of the librarian in the 21st century. According to Gaiman, we used to live in a world in which there wasn't enough information. Now we are in a world in which there's too much information. There's information absolutely everywhere. Google will bring you back, 100,000 answers. A librarian will give you back the right one. In the digital library environment, ebooks, e-journals purchased individually or as part of databases, which contain a host of other resources as well in digital format, or ebooks and e-journals as part of open access resources, form integral part of any college library collection. We all know that. The librarians acquire, organize, store, integrate, and usually disseminate information resources such acquired resources to a dedicated website. Library resources are digitized and institutional repositories have been created. Librarians provide guidance to faculty and students alike in retrieving the right information at the right time, using the right resource from the maze of information sources, evaluating information sources, and ethical use of information. The increasing availability of digitized resources allows educational institutions to provide students with more varied, more accessible, and richer teaching materials than ever before. This encourages a mere exploratory, research-based approach to teaching and learning. Entirely new kinds of topics and courses can be studied, new modes of assignments, new modes of assessment are possible, and students are given a richer educational experience. Nowadays, higher education courses are increasingly becoming blended or hybrid courses, combining a mix of face-to-face and online elements. E-learning, online learning, blended learning are gaining ground. Along with traditional classroom teaching, massive open online courses are increasingly becoming important. Teachers are taking recourse to Moodle to create interactive teaching modules. Here, I would like to point out to another paradigm shift in the role of libraries, which I feel has taken place with this pandemic situation. I would like to point out that online learning has been gradually gaining ground along with traditional classroom teaching. But due to this pandemic situation and the closure of schools, colleges, and universities, online teaching has suddenly become the only method of teaching learning. Not getting access to physical resources of the library or limited access, teachers and students have become all the more dependent or totally dependent on e-resources. In this context, the role of academic librarians have expanded. They are providing resources to students for completing assignments related to curriculum, for their research projects, and also for competitive examinations. They are also introducing them to different coursewares available worldwide and integrating them with library interface. Librarians are providing references to teaching community for preparing assignments, guidelines regarding availability of different LMS or learning management system for creation of e-content, different tools and latest technology that can be adapted for capturing lectures along with PowerPoints, videos, YouTube videos, and integrating them. Faculty need support in these activities as finding appropriate information resources for creating good course content and techniques of presenting are key to success in e-learning. Tremendous amount of information is being generated now. Along with class lectures, teaching modules created by the faculty of the institution, librarians can integrate suitable instruction materials and lectures in various subjects created worldwide by different academic institutions and available in YouTube channels, along with that podcasts, different open source courseware, and MOOCs for the benefit of student and teaching community. Since we are flooded with such materials, these are to be filtered and classified according to the needs of the faculty and students for knowledge enrichment. In addition to library websites and blogs, librarians are making use of tools like creating Facebook page, Twitter, YouTube channels, etc. to communicate with faculty and students for providing information and keep them updated. Dedicated email may be provided for reference service where teachers and students can send their queries regarding library service or reference queries. We all know some common reference sources that are used by the college libraries. Like we are providing information to NLIST, NDLI. We are providing links to some very authentic websites, ebooks and journals, as I have already said, purchased or part of databases or open access resources. And we give links to newspaper databases, we provide content service, And in this phase of pandemic, I would rather say close down, lockdown, different publishers like Oxford, Cambridge, Sage, EBSCO are giving free access to their resources. In addition, so we can utilize all these for giving information. In addition to information regarding curriculum, we can give information regarding scholarships, studies, competitive examinations, and employment for future of the students. A host of books are available freely online, not only reference books, but fiction and all that. To promote reading among students during this situation, online book review competition and quizzes can be organized. Now admission is going on, new session will soon start, so online orientation can be conducted for students. What I would like to say is, before lockdown started, online learning was a choice according to convenience, depending on available of facilities like smartphone, laptops, high-speed data connection, etc. Now it has become compulsion, the only method of teaching learning. We have already been promoting use of digital resources. That has become most important now, in fact, the only source of information. During the pandemic and consequent lockdown, we need to continue to provide these services with greater effort and after the pandemic as well, because we all realize that once colleges and universities open, we'll have to provide restricted services to users, as the keynote speaker, respected keynote speaker, has already mentioned. However, at the end, I would like to point out that all these are possible only for a section of the society. Students in rural areas are deprived of this benefit, and they will continue to suffer if the problem of digital divide is not solved. I would like to end my speech here. Thank you all.
Thank you, thank you, Ms. Moni Ghosh. Thank you for your informative discussion. Now I do request another speaker, Dr. Sudeep Banerjee, to deliver his lecture.
Good afternoon to all. I am honored for getting this invitation to deliver my lecture in this webinar, along with such knowledgeable persons like Professor Dr. Aurobindo Maiti, Dr. Subal Kumar Barui, Dr. Ashish Kumar Karun, and Ms. Bonnie Ghosh. I convey my thanks to Dr. Sanjeev Kumar Das, Vice Principal of Bhairav Ganguly College, and other teaching and non-teaching staff members of this college to jointly organize this seminar. I am really thankful to my teacher, respected Dr. Biplab Chakraborty, Professor of Liberian Information Science, University of Calcutta, and today's webinar director, and members of InfoLib Academia, especially Abul, my friend Abul and Mintu, for providing us this platform to discuss on library services during COVID-19 pandemic, strategies for academic life. My focus of lecture will mainly be on college libraries that provide services to UG colleges. As we all know that the COVID-19 pandemic situation bound the academic institution throughout the globe to stop directly. The situation also blindsided academic life. According to a study of UNESCO, as of May 2020, 69.3% of the world's student population, which counts approximately 1.21 billion, are still out of direct teaching of school and college. Most of the college libraries were not prepared to control this situation. However, they are trying their best to provide services to their students. Now it is presumed that any day, today or tomorrow, the college will open as well as the library will also be open. But it is now presumed that the COVID-19 pandemic is likely to continue for at least 1 to 2 years, and we have to plan accordingly. Another point I also want to mention here, the new education policy of Government of India, where emphasis was given to the building of digital infrastructure, digital content, and capacity building to look after the education needs of both school and higher education. Keeping all these parameters in my mind, I have tried to suggest some services for UG college libraries which can be introduced after the reopening. First of all, what are we now providing? Actually, the entire college library has the right to access NLIST, the college component of e-social. Mainly, the libraries are providing NLIST access to their students by registering them in NLIST portal. A lot of open access resources are also available, and we are trying for providing links of them to the students. We are helping them to access the NDLI service. But my point is that whether the UG college students really getting services as per their need during this closure or not. So first of all, I have to think, I have to study what is the need of the present day UG college student. Abu, please keep the slide and came to the ninth slide. Actually, there are the services offered by the library as all our professional colleagues know about them. So I will not repeated them. So I am just coming to the next stage, that what is the present status and user needs in the college. First of all, I pointed out one thing, that the resources which are available online are mainly for postgraduate students, research scholars and faculty members. Undergraduate students, resources are very few in number. And whatever the resources available for undergraduate students, most of them are from science and technology subjects, few are from social science. But for humanities, there are almost very little resources. There are some technological barriers also. Most of the students are still not digitally literate how to use these resources for their benefit. Network facility is not available in each and every corner of our country. A lot of students have no smartphone. Some of our smartphones, that they are not able to use internet data due to financial reason or for any other reason. And there are some language barrier also. Most of the students depends on the local language. Just like in West Bengal, they are mostly depends mainly. Maybe they give their exam in English, but for studying, they mainly depends on Bengali. But educational resources in Indian local languages, and in particular in Bengali language, are very few in number. And unfortunately, still today, the present education system mainly depends on textbooks and the resources provided by the teacher. At the closure phase, that is the lockdown phase, students are not getting any textbook from their library. Now discussion, next slide. Now discussions are occurring about the reopening of campus. Academic libraries, next slide, will face a paradigm shift. Instead of returning to normal, librarians will be returning to a new normal where in-person service interaction may be impossible or no longer preferred, where collections in physical format may be a barrier to access, and where collaborative study is impossible in favor of social distance. So what will be the future of print collection? Whether they will be relevant after the reopening, we have to think about that. We have to think about the issue return, because the circulation dates don't become hot zones of traffic and disease spread zones. We have to think about the new access model for e-resources. Just for example, I want to tell you that some academic libraries have the access of COPAS and Web of Science with institutional IP. But during this closure, when we are at home, we are not able to use them. Libraries may try to convert the access to user ID and password approach. They have to talk with the, obviously, the SCOPAS and Web of Science authority. We have to think the policies for special collections, which materials are often hidden in halls, only available for in-person access. And today, some librarians are emphasizing on collaborative studies. But after lockdown will over, or when the reopen with the college library will happen, it will not be preferred. Besides this, we have to limit the number of patrons in our library. One of the most important aspects of the online teaching is that copyright challenge. It is unfortunate that many of the faculty members and students don't understand what is copyright, what is fair use, how, after which limit we can use the copyrighted material. The teachers only concerned with making content available to their students. As courses go online, they will want greater access to materials to use in their courses. Librarian must provide more copyright education to the faculty members and the students. At present, library website represents the primary path of interaction for patrons, but we have to make it more user-friendly, responsive, and customizable. Furthermore, you must remember that use of open access resources, OERs, open educational resources, will increase. And last, I want to mention here that PAJE, I think detailed discussions are not required because all the librarians are familiar with the term PAJE. We must remember that PAJE will not increase, but may be decreased in the coming. Now, what type of services we may provide in the UG college life? Next slide. We have to think about, first of all, I want to think about what will be the use of print textbooks. After reopening, a major portion will come to issue textbooks from the library. Academic libraries have to think about the issue return point. They may think to expand the borrowing period from 14 days to 1 month, to introduce book bank facility if it is not available at present. They may introduce specific time for different types of users to avoid the gathering in the circulation days. Obviously, we are trying to build institutional repository. We must give greater importance on that. We can keep resources provided by the faculty members, but I want to mention that we should try to make those resources useful for UG level. We may try to design a gateway of online knowledge on a particular subject, which will act as a single point of access to all available online information as well as a gateway of resources. We may try or motivate our teachers to translate the English resources in the local, that means the Bengali language. We may help our faculty members preparing open educational resources. We may help them in searching and selecting OERs using generic search engines such as Google or dedicated OER search engines such as CC Search. We may help them for using specific OER repositories by identifying the OERs with open licensing, by checking the quality and authenticity, identifying the resources which can be easily mixed or modified to fit a specific learning context. We may help teachers in OER creation or in remixing the OER. One important aspect regarding the OER is its license. Next slide. A common misconception is that OER belongs in the public domain and everyone can use in the way he or she wants. However, we, the Alliance professionals, know that that is not the case. An open license defines how others can use a particular OER. Creative Commons, which was launched in 2002, is currently the most used open license in OER. Here is the chart, the regularly used CC licenses. We are all familiar with the term CC BY, CC BY SA, CC BY NC or ND. So we have to alert our faculty members and students about the CC license. And we can help our teachers to design MOOC. That is the online course that supports unlimited participation and open access via the web. We must think about the training of students to use e-resources. We must start awareness service for both students and teachers about copyright and fair. I wanted to highlight three more awareness services relevant to the today's day when we are using maximum use of internet. That's a awareness to fake news, cyberbullying, and cyber security. We know that the fake news, next slide, fake news or misinformation has a long history. But the term fake news became popular in the year 2016 at the time of Donald Trump's elections in US as the US president. The main concern about the fake news is that it has the ability to polarize society. Behind the success of fake news is its social engagement. Some of my colleagues, we are very familiar with them. So he shares some news, so it must be okay. It must be authentic. We always think that. But we have to think that the fake news can affect a lot of danger in our life. A few days earlier, one of my friends shared that you may use oximeter that is available in the as a mobile app. You just keep your finger on the camera, then the app will tell you that what is the oxygen level in your body. I just tell them that it's a fake, it may be dangerous. Just 2 or 3 days or 4 days after, I come in the newspaper that one person already lost 5 lakhs amount from his bank using this app of oximeter. So we must be aware about the fake news. Already ICLA makes an infography how to spot objects. We may share this in our libraries. It is the infographic designed by the ICLA. Here it is mentioned that how you can check the what is how to spot the fake news. You consider the source. You check the credibility of the author. You don't go only by headlines. You go to the details. You check the supporting sources. We must share this infographic in our website or notice board so that every user can view this and be aware. If any news become viral in very short time, we may check its authenticity and can share it with our users. As a current awareness service, there are a lot of fact-checking sites. Some of them are factchecker.in, factchecker Washington Post, BBC Reality Check, India Today Fact Check, Tip Media, mainly to check health information. And now, Government of India are giving daily useful alerts on COVID-19 to MyGov Corona News. We may check the information from here. Next, it is come cyberbullying. Next slide. Cyberbullying is or cyber harassment, whatever we can tell, is a next is a form of bullying or harassment using electronic means. Next slide. The effects of cyberbullying on teenagers can range from lower school attendance, increased stress and anxiety, feelings of isolation and fear, poor concentration, depression, anything. We may aware our students how to deal with cyberbullying and also giving them moral boosting that they are not alone. They may share their problems to you, that is to a librarian, any librarian or any teachers, if they face any cyberbullying. And at last, I want to share cyber security. Just like our young days, till today, when students came in college after completing their school, they think that they become adults. And sometimes they do some activities which are actually dangerous for them. Use of internet makes this situation more dangerous. We may aware our students about cyber security. We may give the suggestion or the policies for password safety. The passwords are the keys to our digital life, so make them strong. Don't share with friends. Change them frequently. We may alert them about mobile safety. They don't use the public Wi-Fi or be careful before installing any apps. Don't click on any unknown links. There is also an important aspect as gaming safety. Nowadays, students are using PUBG and so more games. That is very dangerous. Frustrations in games can turn into personal conflict with the potential to be very scary and even dangerous. Be aware about it. And don't be afraid you feel you don't know in real life. To protect your privacy, you remember that nowadays, different companies are checking the incumbent's personal social media account before recruiting them. So don't use anything or don't share anything embarrassing pictures or of yourself or any other questionable material in the social media. We can award our students like this. And measures what to be adopted at the time of reopening. My previous lecture, Professor Maiti had already mentioned those. I want to mention one more thing, that provision of masks and gloves along with the training of staff in their removal and disposal. Disposal is also useful. We are using masks and gloves and somebody is kept in anywhere. So we must be aware about the disposal. And obviously there we should maintain as a library staff documentation of procedure or cross training so that anybody can play sick, so anybody can take over or seek employment. So before concluding my session, I tell to my colleague that from today, be ready for tomorrow and prepare yourself. Today, we mainly focusing on the technology rather than content and service. Technology is needed for the smooth functioning, obviously. But for a good library, main focus should be on their users' needs. Before reopening the library, librarians should rethink about their collection, services, and offerings. Thank you. There are the list of references. Thank you.
Banerjee, thank you for your informative discussion. Now, I do invite Dr. Ashish Kumar Karan, librarian, Kalipoddo Ghosh Torai, Mahabiddyalaya Bagdogra. Please, Ashish.
Hello everyone, good afternoon. Am I audible?
Yes.
Thank you, Professor Biplab Chakraborty, Director of InfoLib Academia, for giving me opportunity to say something in this webinar. It is indeed really a great initiative for creating such a platform where from InfoLib Academia can organize series of webinar in the LIS field. Today webinar is the first webinar. Before going to share my idea on present discussion, I would like to give thanks and my heartfelt respect to my teacher, Dr. Biplab Chakraborty, Professor, Department of Library Information Science, University of Calcutta, and Dr. Aurobindo Maiti, Professor, Department of Library Information Science, University of Calcutta, and today's keynote speaker. My sincere thanks to collaborator as well as patron of the webinar, Dr. Sanjit Kumar Das, Vice Principal, Bhairav Ganguly College, for giving us opportunity to say something in this platform. Finally, my sincere thanks to my friends, Dr. Sheikh Abul Salam and Mr. Mintu Haldar, the joint convener of the webinar, for conducting this webinar series and giving us technological help. Now I would say and share my idea on today's discussion. Although my previous speakers already said the present situations of the library and how they are giving services and what are the problems they are facing for giving services, and keynote speaker already giving some suggestions when library will be reopening after COVID-19 pandemic situation. Apart from all this discussion, I would like to share my idea about what we are traditionally provide services from a library. That is pre-COVID library. Library play a fundamental role in society. The resources and services they offer to create opportunity for learning, support literacy and education. Library guaranteeing access to knowledge by physical books, journals, physical space, that is reading room facility, book, journals, issue and return facilities, cataloging service, OPEX search, reference service, photocopy service, online search service, digital books, online books, multimedia contents, career guidance service, newspaper service, and employment related information service. That is traditional library provide services before COVID situation. Now the situation is already changed. Because of pandemic COVID-19, that is coronavirus. Coronavirus spread whole around the world. As a result, all the educational institutions are closed. At the same time, all types of libraries, including national libraries, are closed. Government declared lockdown, closures of institutions, office, etc. As a result, impact directly on academic and research activity. That is, teaching, research, writing, learning, everything totally stopped. impact on library and information centers also, that is closure of library. And everyone is going to work from home and working from remotely. And library also cannot deny his role in this situation. That is, library perform its role and librarian also performing their role from home by arranging online programs to the faculty, researcher, scholar and students. Because information needs is always prevail. Without information, we cannot survive. Without information, we cannot provide our teaching learning courses. Therefore, information need is very essential during COVID-19. Teaching, research and learning resources need faculty members, students, research scholars, policy holders, administrators. Everywhere information is very much needed. Because without information, without adequate information, faculty member cannot prepare lecture notes, presentations, they cannot provide, deliver lectures, they cannot conducting any workshops, seminars, conferences. Meeting cannot be possible without adequate materials, that is online or offline. Writing journal articles, books, research cannot be possible without the information. That is, our information changing behavior is already changed. That is, users' information seeking behavior already changed. Now they are using information instead of libraries, books, journals and other reading materials and peer-reviewed reading materials. They are searching information from online access portals or access gateway. Google-like search engines are not the sufficient to get e-content. Speed and convenience of electronic access over the physical library is not possible because of closures of library. High-quality metadata for the discovery process is very much needed. And discovery to delivery system is to be implemented now. Millennials and teenagers, that is, those are using phones, laptop, iPad. They are using information from online sources or digital mode. Now, information should be overloaded if we are not generating and disseminating information correctly. Therefore, digital or online resources can ensure continuity as COVID put breaks to the academic activity of present days. Although online learning and resources has been around the world over last decades, but online learning and online resources has hard its task cut out on many reasons. Because of teachers and students lacking digital skill. Lacking digital skill, they cannot access information from everywhere and anytime. Digital divide is there. That is, lack of device availability in the remote section, students and teachers. Internet accessibility is there. Adoption of technology is also a barrier. Academic credibility of faculty is a question, because how they should be created, online lectures, online resources, online writing, it is not possible for all the faculty members in academic institutions, from college, school and in a university level. And there is a question of privacy also. Privacy is a very important fact, because every information cannot be shared and every and each information sources cannot be accessed. And this is the high time that society may understand the importance of libraries and role of librarian for organizing and disseminating the information accurate information can only be provided by librarians only. In that case, we can say Google is a library. No, Google is a trustworthiness. Google has trustworthiness. No, because Google or any standard research engine provide only just 15% to 20% of web content. Rest are not available to users. Not only that, authentic source are not accessed from Google. While searching on Google, you may not get most relevant results. There is a lack of relevance in ranking. How to deal with this information overload or explosion? Rather, I can say information pollution. So there is a vital role of library and librarian to cater this kind of right information at the right time to the right user. So there are many issues. These issues are content development and management of digital software, developing online and digital collection, institutional repositories, copyright issues, DMR, digital right management, mobile technology, open access option and choices, virtual library, authentication and authorization, remote access technology, federated search, web scale discovery service, traditional face-to-face reference service, web-based virtual reference service, social network, reference and data management, engaging with academic community, online learning and teaching tools, and interactive website. At the outset of online platform cannot replace formal educational institutions. However, at this time of crisis, we need to evolve innovative method of learning and online education system that can be answered our problem. Some of the teaching and learning tools are here: Zoom, Google Meet, Webex, Skype for Business, GoToWebinar. Today we are virtually meet each other with webinar, go to meeting, Microsoft team, and join me with several platforms are there. Now the question is education and library services during COVID. Previously, we already said everything is closed, educational system and library. So everything can be reopened during COVID through online system, in online mode. That is online classes, virtual classes, work from home, conference calls to connect each other, online conferences, distance and online learning, MOOCs, virtual meeting, online examinations, online evaluations, digital library, digital archives, digital repository, library portal, and different modules. Gateway of knowledge can be only possible with online and digital forms. Research and browse, access anytime, anywhere can be possible only if we can provide online resources through online medium. Digital library centers may also be treated as learning resources. Now the question is, Digital Library Status in India. Academic institutions started their functioning from school library, college library, university library, research library, public libraries, subject national libraries, National Library of India, National Publishing Industry, Library Professional Library Systems is there. These are all library types. But each and every library cannot provide service through online mode or digital mode, because millions of school library are there, which are remotely located without any connectivity. They cannot provide online learning resources, online learning materials, online platform. Nowadays, with the initiative from the Government of India and Government of West Bengal, several colleges started online platform for sharing information with the help of Google Classroom, Google Meet, WhatsApp chat, and several other things. College library also digitized to some extent documents and learning materials for giving information to their users. More or less, university library sufficient in this category. They are sufficient to provide digital resources to their users. Few public libraries are there. They also provide digital information. Subject National Library and National Library of India nowadays provide different types of resources from KG to PG users. And different types of national digital libraries initiatives are there. Digital Library of India, National Virtual Library of India, Center for Excellence National Digital Preservation Program, Book and Delivery at Ineffectible Legal Deposits, E-Shoot Sindhu Consortia, that is InfliNet, UGC, MHRD Consortia, National Library Programs. These libraries are not sufficient for providing digital resources. Now, how we can develop our digital content? That is, digital content may be digitized or born digital. Subscribed or e-resources, e-journal, open access resources, imaging, maps, media, free content, research data, cooperative projects. Few are the digital libraries, and there are digital library from where we can access digital content. And these are the digital library, that is NDLI. I am giving some web address from where we can freely access digital content. But the question is that, are the digital library are enough to provide and fulfill our requirement? I think no, because sometimes we need much more information. Actually, digital library provide information which are indexed and properly bibliographically arranged. But there is some substitution where from we can get sufficient information. That is from deep web. What is deep web? Deep web is referred to data which are not indexed by any standard search engine such as Google or Yahoo. Deep web refers to all web pages that search engines cannot find. Search user database, that is possible only registrations and IP base, and required web forums, web mail pages, and pages behind the paywalls. That is, we have to pay something for this database. Deep web, sometimes we can call it invisible web or hidden web, that are part of the world wide web whose contents are not indexed and standard search engines are not for that. The opposite term of the deep web is the surface web. Essence of deep web resources. Deep web resources, that is dynamic pages. They can give us query rightly if we access in a particular form. Unlinked contents. Contents are not properly linked. We have to know the link or know the search mechanism where from we can search the information. Or some private pages are there. Some sites are there where we need to register and they give us ID and password from where we can access, and resources can be provided to our users. Limited access web. Sites are captured or no cache pragma HTTP headers. That is, we cannot access in general web mechanism. There are some script pages are also there. These pages also produced with the JavaScript, Flash and Ajax, which are not usually linked to any web page or any website. And these are all HTML contents or multimedia files, that is image or video, that can be accessed through virtual server or from mirroring server. That side we can show that generally we are searching the surface web, that is Google or like any academic search engine may help us to search. After that layer, there are deep web. Deep web, in deep web, there are so many academic information and resources are there. If we know the mechanism, we can access our desired information, desired document, desired records from the deep web. And lastly, the dark web. Dark web, we did not. Most of the porn sites, online video, everything are accessed from dark web. Now the question is, how we can search deep resources? Deep resources and sources are searched with the help of two particular search engines. Search engines to search the deep web. That is semantic search tools or databases. Metadata search engine like academic index, general search engines and databases, why Elasticsearch, academic search engines and databases, Google Scholar, scientific search engine and databases, GoPubMed, collaborative information databases, Dell ICO US, and so many databases are there for deep web. Open access search engines are there, that is core. What are the technology to access these remote resources? That is, remote access technologies are needed. Point-to-point protocols, PPP. RADIUS, remote authentication, dial-in user service. TACACS, that is terminal access controller, access control system, VPN, virtual private network and tunneling, PPTDES, point-to-point tunneling protocol, L2TP, layer 2 tunneling protocol, IPsec, Internet Protocol Security, ISS, Secure SSL, IEEE 802.18, only 19% resources are not accessible. 92%, that is 81% resource can be accessed from OF, deep OF. Now the question is, how big is deep? Deep OF. The deep OF contains 7500, that is 7500 terabytes of information. The surface OF in comparison contains only 19 terabytes of content. We are using in digital form of authenticated source is only 19 terabytes. But in deep OF contains 7500 terabytes. Deep OF has between 400 to 550 times more public information than the surface OF. More than 2 lakh deep OF sites currently exist. I don't know how many of us are very much aware of this, that number existing in the deep OF. Together, the 60 largest deep OF sites contain around 750 terabytes of data. Total quantity of deep OF is 1000 to 2000 times greater than the quality of surface OF. 550 billion individual documents can be found on the deep OF compared to the surface OF, 1 billion individual documents. 95% of the deep OF is publicly accessible, meaning no fees, no subscription. Nothing we have to pay for that. I am giving the sources where from collected by information. Present deep OF search scenario. Deep OF can be searched with the federated search, Google searching, Meta search or Discovery search engine. What is discovery service? Search interface to pre-indexed metadata or full text document. Generally, we search indexed document. But in the discovery service, we can search pre-indexed document and pre-indexed metadata. Single simple entry point. Single simple entry point can access a huge source of information. Research pre-index data, return research results more quickly. And evaluation beyond federated search, which is the technology of 2002-04 only. Now, our search engine and search techniques are already established in the market, and most of the information scientists are searching with this search engine. Provide integration with federated searching or provide API, that is application programming interface, for others to provide integration. Now the other search strategy is web scale search or federated search. With this search engine, we can search ILS data, digital collection, ProQuest, ML library, ABC CLIO, and pre-built harvesting and indexing, non-harvesting information also. Now the question is, all this digital library and open OF or deep OF is sufficient? Sometimes the answer is no, as because no library of the world can subscribe or purchase and can link all resources in their website. To reduce the time gap between information rich and information poor, we need open access policy. The internet provides a new opportunity to bring information to a wider audience at virtually no marginal cost and allow them to use it in new innovative ways for regenerating information openly accessible to the beneficial for the researcher, institutions, public, businessmen, policymaker, and administrators. And there are some linked open data for cultural heritage and digital humanities from where we can provide information. These are the list and their percentage I am giving here. Promoting open access in India. National open access policy like Plan S in Europe. There is a Plan S Europe for open access policy for generating open access information. There are institutional level policy, stop predatory publishing. That is, there are several softwares are there. With this, we can stop predatory publishing and removing duplication, removing copying, and removing cut paste methodology. Library can promote open access with the users by creating awareness about the benefit of open access to all the stakeholders, by giving membership to open access, by implementing open access repository, by supporting open access journals, creating open access portal, developing advocacy programs on campus, off campus, through the library website, and through membership in other library organizations. That is creation of library cooperation and consortium for giving information. With these open resources and deep web, we can give better service to our users, that is to our faculty members and students, for creating their knowledge resources, for creating their video lectures, lecture notes, presentation, everything. Now the question is, after COVID, that is post-COVID-19, library and library services, what will be their nature? After the situation is over, that is post-COVID-19, library will be a hybrid library system. That is, physical resources will be there and online resources will be there. My previous speakers already said many things about safety measures when library will be reopening. I am not repeating all these things. I just mention only few points. With the hybrid library system implementing, we can give research and reference help to our research scholar by one-to-one through phone meeting with the help of Zoom, Microsoft Team meeting. We ask their requirements, hard documents, and provide them with the email. We can use Ask Librarian Chat service. In our web page, we can make chat service and give them answer and fulfill the student's requirement in real time through virtual system. The link of the service will be available in our library web page. We can provide document scanning service. With this service, we scan and send document as they required with the PDF format, through email, through WhatsApp, online document delivery system we can introduce with a WhatsApp group. As we know, our faculty members are creating online classes, online lectures through WhatsApp. And in my college, I request the authority to add each WhatsApp group to my number or library number, so that I can access what is going there and what the faculty member are giving lectures on what topic, so that I can send them these materials with this forum. Book loan and book renewals should be done with electronically, and other services is already mentioned my previous speaker. I am not repeating all these things. From my point of view and from my work sphere, I create a library web page where from I am giving different kinds of services to my users, that is our students and faculty members. They are giving feedback, they are giving requirements. If you go through this link, you can see this web page where every type of information is there, what the students are required. And this kind of web page is created freely with the help of WordPress. Everyone can create such type of website. Even department wise, you can create web page where from you get 3D space and sufficient of information link and document you can upload there. And this is my initiative during COVID-19. Thank you all. This is about my discussion. Thank you everyone for giving me opportunity to share my little idea or experience on the discussion. Thank you all.
Thank you, Dr. Ashish Karan, for your wonderful discussion and the initiative taken by you during this COVID-19 situation. And thank you for your initiatives taken in your college. And you have discussed a lot in terms of the skill of the users and as well as the skill of the teachers in using the digital library, and the relevance of Google teaching and learning tools. You have discussed the online educational resources compatible with the online platform. So deep resources, deep web search scenario, all everything. A number of areas you have covered, but time is short. Because of time constraints, you will not be able to justify everything. And initially, I talked about the series of webinar, but this is the webinar. Here we have not about the series of webinar, but you know that we will be organizing a series of webinar. Yes, what you have talked about that, because online teaching, learning, and evaluation, MOOC, and e-contents creation, organization, management, and the challenges and ways, learning management system, then opportunities and benefits, virtual library services, tools and techniques for preservation of documents,
and the results on health issues, innovations and the dissemination of the results on health issues to the common people, agriculture information services to the people, use of social media, and there are merits and demerits and more, and a number of topics such will be discussing through such webinar individually or jointly. So yes, we will do that. But now I do request you, Dr. Subal Kumar Baroi to deliver his lecture, please. And after that, questions are there. A number of questions are coming. So you, all of you are ready to answer those
questions.
You will get the answers.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, please, Subal.
Good afternoon, everybody. At first, I would like to sincere gratitude to my teacher, guide, Professor Biplab Chakraborty, Professor, Department of LIS, University of Calcutta. And I also like to thank Dr. S.K. Dash, Vice Principal, Bhairav Ganguly College, and Joint Convener, Dr. S.K. Salam, and Dr. Mitbu Haldar, and esteemed colleague and professionals, thank you for the listening our webinar. Now I am concentrating on the university library services during the COVID-19. What we provide the services towards our teaching teachers, faculty members, and students. Basically, I want to inform you that what are the university system of our library system of our university. The University of Calcutta library system consists of central library, 5 campus library, 39 departmental libraries, and 4 libraries of the advanced studies, which are spread over all 8 major campuses in around Calcutta, South Chobbish Porgona and North Chobbish Porgona. Basically, the collections of the university library, what are the collection we have? There we have near about 10 lakh books, 10 lakh books, a number of journals near about 2 lakh bound volume journals, PhD thesis near about 11,900, even medical dissertation, which are submitted by the MD student, near about 11,500, and total number of e-journals titles are near about 7,500. And we have also e-books, approx 8,000 titles. Our university library, during the period of COVID, we have also list of digital resources. We have uploaded the university website for the purpose of research, study, teaching, full text PhD thesis, which are since 1960 to 2018. And there are so much, very much useful collection of PRS dissertations, which are Premchand Raichand's dissertation, which is basically it's a fellowship of the MA student. Calcutta Review, which are started in the 1844. It's basically the pioneer journal of the West Bengal as well as Calcutta. It's basically the content of this journal is culture, society, science, technology, and politics. The university also digital resources, Calcutta University published by the university library. Calcutta University published the university books which are digitized by the university library near about 1177 title, and some departmental journals which are science, commerce and arts, all are digitized here. Ebong this basically the convocation speech, Tagore Law lecture, famous Tagore Law lecture delivered by eminent lawyer, distinguished personnel and eminent persons of the society, different university commission report, minutes of the syndicate, senate, etc., university acts, university statute, university ordinance, which are the wealthy resources for research and reading facility for the university scholar, faculty members, as well as around the globe, anyone can access this type of digital resources, along with university regulation, university calendar, university old question paper. It's a question paper which are content from the 1891 to 1980, near about 100 years, from ISC level to honors ebong master degree and master degree level, university old syllabi, all are available in the in our university website. Miscellaneous report of the university, budget address by delivered by the different distinguished provincial chancellor, finance and other officials of the university, annual account accounts, budget, financial estimate, annual reports, which are available in the university website. In this, along with this, we have home and off campus access to ebooks, e journal, e databases, and also access to Elsevier Scopus. And we also along with some educational portal, we have organized the university website, and Vidyamitra, EPG Pathshala, there are so many library systems during the COVID. This period we have delivered checking and the thesis, article, dissertations of PhD scholar, teacher, students of our university by Urkund, uploading study material as well as e-content on the university website, providing institutional email ID to our teachers, faculty members. They have contact with the other organization for their institutional email through institutional email IDs. E-content delivery service. We have always the university librarian, deputy librarian, assistant librarians. We have provided e-content delivery service through email. We want to guide the scholar, e-library services, and university also recently G Suite online teaching platform for the faculty members. And basically we need the help of different publishers of the famous publisher who have assigned to us the remote access, and we downloading the article to the required information to these scholars, faculty members and teachers. These are the university service during the COVID. Thank you all. Basically, these are the university library services during the COVID situation. Thank you all.
Thank you, Dr. Subal Kumar Varoi, Deputy University Librarian of the Calcutta University. Thank you for your brief and pinpointed speech. Now, I do request all the speakers to be prepared for getting some questions from the participants. I am reading. Whether I will ask the questions to the particular speaker or anybody of you can give the answer, because Sudeep, Ashish, Aurobindo, yes, Bonnie, yes, all you are present. Bonnie, are you present? Yes. Bonnie is not present? Yes.
Present. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, one question from Rukshana Sultana, that how can we raise open access materials? These questions to Bonnie Ghosh. No, open, not for particular one. Anybody
okay, okay,
can.
Okay, okay, okay. Sir, pardon, please. One second question.
How can we raise open access materials? How can we raise open access materials?
How can we
rise, extend, and expand? How can we rise open access material? How can
expand,
we extend?
Extend. Basically, extend.
Yes. Okay.
How can it be growth? Yes, then anybody of you can give the answer.
Actually, in my presentation, I am giving several open access repository from where we can access open access resource material.
Okay. Then can you share the answer to those participants?
Yes, sir. It will send by
mail. Sir, in my presentation, there are several open access initiatives in India, from where we can collect. That is, collection building can be possible from these resources.
Sir, one more thing, we can access a lot of e-content courseware on UG subjects from the cec.nic.in. There are Swam Prabhat, that is a DTH channels devoted to telecasting high quality educational programs. There are Shodh Ganga, Shodh Gangotri, UG and PG books, which are the repository of Swam books. A lot of repositories which are mentioned in Dr. Ashish Kumar Karun's lecture. We can go through them to raise the open access materials and include them to our content using the common Creative Commons licenses.
Sir, also, okay. Also it will the discuss about the Vidyamitra, EPG Patsala, NLLID, Hathitas Digital Library. All are the access to all the open access repositories. You can access all these things.
Okay. Then next question is how library professionals can you hear me?
Oh, yes, sir.
Yes.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very much audible, sir.
How library professionals will provide their library services online when they are facing the problems like digital divide and a slow or bad network connection?
Sir, it is impossible to provide online collection to users.
This question
is
from Dr.
Pradeep Bharchas
to Ms. Bonnie Ghosh.
Okay, yes, sir, one thing. This type of question. Queries after having this question.
How library professionals will provide their library services online when they are facing the problems like digital divide and slow and or bad network connections. I would like to tell you that at the end I have said that whatever I have talked about is only for a section of the society. Most of the, particularly in rural areas, students and teachers as well do not have this facility. We are talking about digital India. We are creating many online courses and all that. But at the same time, initiative should be taken so that students and teachers of rural areas, they get access to laptops or smartphones and high-end internet connectivity. Not only that, recently we have seen that one university has taken the initiative of distributing smartphones as well as high-end internet.
What happens?
Maybe technological problems, sir. What is the question is? Actually, the question is that, and that has happened practically.
Sorry, sir, my internet connection is getting disrupted. My internet connection is getting disrupted. I'm very sorry, sir. And I would like to end by saying that when students and teachers of rural areas, particularly I will focus on students, when they get hold of, and ultimately when they get hold of laptops or smartphones or internet connectivity, librarians have a very important role to play. Like librarians are responsible for information literacy. I think when this situation is that they finally get something, hold up something, it is the librarians' responsibility to introduce them to e-resources. I think they may have limited access to e-resources in their college libraries, but when they get used to, I mean, they will have to get used to the smartphones. They will have to be introduced to the e-resources and how to integrate with these e-resources with their curriculum. So librarians have a great role to.
Again, network connection problem.
Yes, sir.
I think the question is relevant.
Question is for digital divide. Digital divide is there.
What I was talking about, that librarians have a great role to play to introduce them to the internet resources, to mobile apps, how to use all those information literacy in a sort of way.
Okay, Bonnie is facing problem. Anybody of you can provide the answer to the participant? Any suggestion from you, Ashish, Sudeep?
Sir, actually,
the question is very pertinent, but this situation can be overcome because during this pandemic situation, most of the parents are providing smartphone to their child, as because from nursery to PG level, online classes are going on. Real time streaming cannot be possible. Access online material and resources nowadays. In 2019, it was 40%. 40% people get access laptop, mobile phone, etc. But during April 2020, it reaches up to 80%. Only remote area are not covered in this network connectivity. But most of the school students are also connected with network connection. At least they have their parents' mobile from where they can get access to nascent information and record information from their teachers, from their faculty members.
Sir, I may just
okay.
No, Sudeep, please. Enough. Next question is another from Dr. Bhatchas to Sudeep Banerjee.
Okay.
Yeah, what's okay, your sir. Valuable suggestion? What's your valuable, what are the valuable suggestions for the library staff regarding information literacy for providing this type of library services? What are the valuable suggestions for the library staff regarding information literacy for providing this type of library services?
Sir, first of all, we have to stay up to date about the technological aspects, whatever is going on around us. And we must attend some short-term courses on if have some problem on technology aspects. There are a lot of MOOCs available which are going on different types of digital library aspects, how to use them, what type of software we may use, how to use the software in our college library or in academic institution. We must attend those courses. And last but not the least, that we must take the help of technology advanced colleagues. They are also available in all types of academic institutions. We have to take the help from them to provide our services if we think that we have some technological aspect types of problems. I think that is my answer.
Okay, Jeb, again, sir, another question.
Sir, there are so many online courses on technological know-how.
Subal, please.
Yes, sir.
Subal, please. Achha, try to be specific because time is completed. Another question from Aditi Mukherjee to Banerjee or anybody of you. Should the libraries make the user aware of technology and its usage techniques as it appears that students from remote places do not even know how to attend a webinar?
Sir, in my lecture, I have already mentioned that. Yes, sir. Actually, in my lecture, I have already mentioned that the UG level college students have this type of problem, and librarians should take an initiative to provide them technological knowledge, how to use the computer, how to use the open access resources, and what is open access resources, how to use them, and how they take benefit of these open access resources, how they take the benefit. And I have already mentioned in my lecture.
Okay. Thank you, the speakers, for answering all the questions raised by the participants in this webinar. Thank you all. I think a number of issues you have raised in this webinar, from keynote speaker to all speakers, suppose categories of services, promoting public health awareness, online databases, a number of online databases, digital divide between haves and have-nots, post-COVID situation, how the reopening of libraries will be made among some initiatives. All these were discussed by the keynote speaker, Professor Aurobindo Maiti, very lucidly and in deeply, because time is short, so that all these areas were not discussed by him elaborately. So, but it was quite informative and quite okay, very good lecture within the time. So, I am very happy to thank Professor Aurobindo Maiti. Next, Bonigas has told about the nature of different job responsibilities in a discussion, and she spoke mainly about blended learning from through online mode. This is very good talk. And next, Sudeep told the different services of the library, because mainly in the undergraduate college library, and their status and users need are to be identified. Changes of collection and operations are to be there. There are different type of suggestive measures and the services and use of mainly using of print and online resources and remixing and revising on already online educational resources. common license, designing MOOCs, identification of fake news, cyber building, cyber security, a number of issues that he raised in his discussion. Thank you, Sudeep. Thank you, Boni Ghosh. And Ashish, as I have already told previously, after his lecture, what is told, so he thought was very important in the forthcoming situation, forthcoming days, and I have already told that as a chairman of the InfoLib Academia, that a number of areas are to be discussed in the forthcoming webinars, either individually or collaboratively with Bhairav Ganguly College or any other college or any other institution, whatever it may be. So I think that that next speaker, Dr. Subol Kumar Baroi, has also spoken about the status and and responsibility and the services provided by the university itself. So I think that the lectures spoken by the different speakers, from keynote speaker to every speaker, because of time constraint, they are not able to get the justice from the different perspectives. So, though it is not totally complete, but I think that it is within a short period or within a time period, the webinar discussion has become fruitful and informative, and will be helpful to the participants and the library professionals who are listening or will be listening. Okay, now I am handing over my microphone to the conveners of the organizers of this webinar to continue the next part of this webinar. Yes, Abul Salam.
Thank you very much, sir. We are at the end of this program. Now, thank you for being very patient, listening to our webinar. And the important announcement is that we will have our next webinar. Already I have displayed that on that screen. You can say here on the bottom. Then our next collaborative webinar, same collaboration with Bhairav Ganguly College. And it will be held on 24th August at the same time, 3 p.m. And our topics is MOOC. We all know that the massive open online courses are very popular nowadays, particularly during this COVID pandemic situation, and how we will teach, that means online teaching learning procedures, how it will happen, particularly during this period and later on through the virtual mode. The main discussion topics will be there on the particular themes, and how at the same time how we will evaluate the students with the help of our deliberation. So that is very much important to us. So please be there with us on 24th August 20 at 3 p.m. And now the time is for vote of thanks. At the first, very first, we would like to thanks. Not only thanks, because our sir will always ask, and he is the mastermind for this program also. Dr. Professor Biplab Chakraborty. He's the webinar director of this series of this webinar.
Chairman. Chairman of the InfoLib
Librarian. InfoLib Academia. This is our professional. It is the platform of connecting to the LIS professionals and teachers, students, as well as scholars. And next, we will be grateful or thankful to Dr. Sanjit Kumar Das. He is the vice principal and the patron of this series of this webinar. And at the same time, Bhairav Ganguly College, all of the staffs of the Bhairav Ganguly College, faculty, non-teaching staffs, for their support and be with us to organize such a good webinar series, particularly our joint convener, Mr. Minthu Hallar, is the librarian at Barsar and also the convener of this joint convener of this webinar series with me. And next, it is time to thankful. We are thankful to Dr. Professor Aurobindo Maithi. He was the key speaker for the day on this particular theme, and he is the professor department of Library Information Science, Calcutta University. We are really thankful for his valuable deliberation of speech, and really we enrich us with his thoughtful discussion. Next, we are very much thankful, Ms. Bonnie Ghosh, she is the librarian of Loreto College. We are really updated ourselves with the help of her thoughtful deliberation. Thereafter, with the deliberation of Dr. Sudeep Banerjee, we are also thankful to him for his beautiful deliberation on this particular theme. Next, we are thankful to Dr. Ashish Kumar Karan. He is the Associate Professor, Skill Librarian of Kalicharan Ghosh Tawai Mahavidyalaya. It is located in North Bengal University. He already told that he has set up a very beautiful web-based information services to his particular staff and teachers community. So I think not only to his college also, as it is designed by WordPress and URL is available to all of us, so you all will be enriched with this platform and the resources available to that particular platform. So really, thank you very much, Dr. Ashish Kumar Karan. And then our Deputy University Librarian, Dr. Subal Kumar Barui, we are also thankful to him. He has delivered such a very informative session to us regarding the information which they have accommodated through the university library portal or university library sites. There are different types of subject gateways also they have accommodated. So he provide all the information on that particular respect to cover up our topics. So thank you very much, Dr. Subal Kumar Barui. And with this, one important announcement also, the certificate will be available to the portal, learning management portal of the Bhairav Ganguly College. And the URL of this portal is MOOCs, that is https://moocs.bgclibrary.in. That is the URL of that particular portal. And you all are requested to register there and enroll on that particular webinar to get your certificate. It will be available within 7 days with that particular portal. So you will be able to download that certificate from that portal. Not only that, this webinar certificate, the certificates of all the webinars series in collaboration with Bhairav Ganguly College, it will be available there in that particular portal. And feedback form also is open now and it is active. So you'll be able to put your valuable feedback now to organize far better way in the next our program. And also it is in there in your email, and it is open now. So please put your valuable feedback. And with this, Mr. Hallar, would you like to say anything?
Thank you, Dr. Salam. Thank you, our teacher. My sincere thanks go to our esteemed participant who have joined this webinar. Dr. Salam already announced we are going to organize 3 more webinars. I request all the participants to register for our next webinar. Over to Dr. Salam.
Yes, and already our director and chairman InfoLib Academy, Dr. Chakraborty, told that we have already delivered the flyer for the next 3. In addition to this, next 3 webinar schedule. The next program title will be on MOOC online teaching learning evaluation. And next, after that, on 29th August, we will have another webinar. And that is also will be held on at the same time. Date is there, and The topics will be, I think it is on
e-content creation, e-content organization and management, challenges yes, and ways.
Challenges and ways. We all know that there is a big role of the LIS professionals, particularly us, in creating the e-content, how to keep the e-content by the teachers, by the faculty members, and how we, the LIS profession, could help or guide the teachers to create their e-content, or after that, how they organize the content and how they manage by us. That will be discussed on that, what will be the challenges and what will be the ways. On that particular topic, we will have the great look on 29th August at 3 p.m. So be there and register yourself. And our, in this series, we will have another webinar on 31st August, 3 p.m., 11:30 a.m. It will be 11:30 a.m. on 31st August. And you know that our very popular teacher, Dr. Partho Sarathy Mukhopadhyay, will be there on the topic Learning Management System, Problems and Prospects. Because we all know that there is a big role of learning management platform in today's environment. So he will look on that particular topic to enrich us. So be there with us for the next webinars. With this, please, sir, conclude the session.
Okay. I have no another word to say. Formally, I am announcing that this webinar is closed.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you all.
Thank you.